Hey guys, I'm back. If you missed my box opening for this Teeny Tinies, that was actually in my previous video, so you might want to go check that out before you watch this. But I received these most adorable little Teeny Tinies clovers, and these were sculpted by Teeny Tinkers. If you don't follow her, you guys might want to go check her out. She's amazing. She's got a YouTube channel, an Instagram, and her own website. So what I did is I actually ordered the kit. Some of the people were able to get full dolls that she had already assembled and sanded and completed and like even done face-ups on and everything. Uh-oh, I've got tape sticking to my directions. Hold on. Instructions. Oh my goodness. But anyway, and guys, I have never worked with 3D printed items before, so this is going to be a learning curve for me. So what it says in the kit instructions is carefully remove all resin pieces from the packaging. There are 22 total pieces. So let's make sure everything is here. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. Hold on. Oh, you know what? Maybe, hold on. Let's just make sure that everything is here. It looks like everything should be here. So we've got, she says 22. Is that right? So the legs, there's 4. The body. Oh, you know why? Because the body, it's probably right. It's an uneven number with the body. So 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 for the head. 10, 11, 12, 13, and then joints, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21. So it's actually 21 pieces, resin pieces. Yeah, because it would be an uneven number because there's only 3 parts to the body. Unless something's missing, I don't think there is though. Everything else has like 2 of each. So, we've got that sorted. and then it says, sand pieces thoroughly. Oops. She recommends using a few grits of sandpaper, finish by buffing with super fine sandpaper or a magic eraser, which she actually included, which was awesome. Wash pieces with soap and water, and then let dry, and then you can string them. Well, I haven't done any of that yet because I wanted to first see if I could remove some of the little supports that were left on the body, and that's probably all that this video is going to be, and I probably won't record all of it, just maybe show you how I'm going to try to do it. So it says somewhere here, oh yeah, here for tips, I noticed it says, if there are any teeny bits of supports left, use sharp pliers to cut them to avoid breaking anything. Now, I only have these pliers, and I'm not sure what it meant by sharp pliers because there's nothing on these to cut that would, oops, I don't think there's anything in these that will cut. So I'm gonna see if these work, but then I also stopped at Ace Hardware yesterday after work and I picked up this like X-Acto knife because I figured for pieces like this where like I don't want to break that off and create a big hole where her eye is supposed to be, and I wonder if I can just kind of shave it off with the X-Acto blade. We're gonna try, guys. You are with me for the journey. So And the reason I decided to get the kit was because it was cheaper and I was able to get two. So I ended up getting two colors of clover, this purple one and the blue one, the baby blue one. So we are going to get this knife out very carefully because I don't want to cut myself. And oh good, it's got a little guard on it. But you know, I figured it would be some good experience to get into trying to prep a 3D printed item myself. So let's see, I don't even know where to start. I'm just gonna kind of feel around on some of these. Oh, like right here. There's like, see that little nub? So some of these I'm gonna have to, oh wait, that's gonna come off by itself. That wasn't even a nub, that, let's see, I should have had something. Oh well, I'll probably just throw away this bubble wrap anyway when I'm done, so I'm gonna just set it aside. Let's see what happens. No judgment, guys, because like I said, I've never worked with 3D printed items before. I'm gonna see if I can just kind of snip on some of the edges. I don't know how this will feel, so we're gonna do it very carefully. Oh, okay. Feels like it came off pretty easily. There's another little nub here. Oh, this is kind of fun. Not as hard as I thought it would be. Oh, wow. Okay, so those little pieces come off pretty easily. But these pliers feel kind of bulky to me, so what I'm going to do, since I now know that it is pretty soft material, I'm going to get my blade out. And I'm going to try and see what happens if I sort of shave at it a little bit. Not too bad. And for pieces down in here. Oh yeah, look at that, guys. And I'm not gonna dig at it with the sharp end. I'm gonna kind of scrape against and see if that works. I thought about going at it like this, like digging towards myself, but then that, I believe, would kind of make notches. So let's see what happens if we sort of scrape against the grain. And there's like a little rough spot right here. So let's see what happens if we... Oh, yeah. Kind of scraping against the grain, or if that's what you would call it. And then I do have some sandpaper. Let's see. I have some really fine sandpaper that I got because I have a BJD body that was modded, that had been partially modded. And I was thinking about finishing the mod myself. This feels really smooth around this edge. So I had already got like some coarse, some medium, and some super fine sandpaper to do that. So I think I will use that to kind of sand over. And it's actually, I think it said it was wet sand, like you could wet sand it or something, which is probably better for resin. Now let's see, there's like, I don't know if I'm doing this right, guys. Like I said, this part I am sort of digging at because just want to try and have a clean cut right there. Did I get it? I think I did. Ooh. So this is working pretty well. 'Cause these pieces are so tiny, as you can tell, I was just afraid to go in with these. Even though they're small pliers, it just felt kind of bulky to me. But, yeah, then this will just need a little sanding, I think, if I use some sandpaper on the edge. So, I don't want this video to go on too long. We've already been like 11 minutes already. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to go for, I'll do some of this intricate work later on my own, off camera. But you see this little eye piece? I've been terrified to touch it. I don't know if I should go in on it with these or if I should try the blade. I think I'm going to try the blade, guys. Oh, okay. And there's like a little chunk on the inside. So, we're going to try, guys. Hopefully I don't like take a big chunk out, but I'm gonna see what happens. Okay. Maybe I should do it from the outside. I don't want to cut myself either. Let's go like, it's hard to see. Let's see if we can do it. I think we're getting it. We are getting it. Okay. Did I do it? Just kind of snapped off. And just try to shape it a little bit better. Yes, guys. I got a little notch there. But I noticed there was a tiny notch in this eye over here too. Can you guys see that? Right there. That was already there. So let's see if we can shape it a little better. I'm going to go against the grain again and scrape with the non-sharp edge. You should see me. I'm concentrating so hard. I'm sitting here with my tongue hanging out. I'm just going to kind of, I'm going to go for it, guys. I'm going to see if I can shape. I'm going to take the blade and scrape in towards that little notch a little bit from each side. That's not bad. And I think if I put little, maybe if I put little lashes on her or something, I might be able to hide those little notches even more. Or you know what? Maybe I can just continue shaping it like this. Oh, I think I can do this. Like kind of scoop at it. This is actually kind of relaxing. You have lots of patience, Rosie, if you're watching this. I know you, oh, nice, okay. I know you did this with several of the full body ones already. You had to go in and prep them yourself. This may slightly change the shape of her eye, but I'm getting rid of that little notch. Oh, yeah, that's pretty good. What do you guys think? Let's go in and see if we can smooth this side. Once again, I'm going to just kind of, I am using the sharp end. And I'm just kind of scooping at it. And then I'm going to scoop at it from this way. I'm getting a little more comfortable with using this blade and working with the resin. So if I decide to try and sculpt ahead, maybe I won't be as scared anymore of doing it myself. Oh, there we go. Oh, I'm getting it, guys. Yay. Wow. So yeah, I'm kind of using my pinky to brace my finger. And I am just scraping along the edge. I'm getting it shaped nice. Nice and smooth. Okay, wow, we did it. I'm going to use the backside of the blade to go around it on the inside to knock off anything that might still be sticking. Check it out. I got it smooth pretty well. What do you guys think? Because you know there were little notches. And I'm going to smooth the bottom. I actually like how this works. It's more precise. You can get in there. You can really get in there with some precision. So leave a comment down below, guys, and let me know if you guys ordered any of Teeny Tinker's clovers and if you got the kit. I would love to hear how you guys did yours, like how you prepped them. Wow, look at that. I'm so happy. So I'm getting her eyes done really nicely. I am happy with that. I think so. I'm a perfectionist too, so it's like I will keep going at it, and I don't want to make her eyes too much bigger, so I'm going to stop here. That's good. And then let's see. This, I can get that buffed with some sandpaper. There's some little spots like that. You see that little white area? Looks like a excuse me. It's like a little blemish there. And let's see. Let's go around on the bottom. A little spot right here. Feels kind of sharp. When I go silent, I'm really concentrating, guys. Are you holding your breath, too, while I'm doing this? Let's see. I feel a little rough spot there. Love how you can just use the backside of the blade and kind of knock things off with it. Because you know if you go in at it with the sharp side, you might take a notch out. So I'm just kind of using the back side. All right. I will work more on that later. Let's see, there was another piece that I really wanted to try on camera. And that's this finger. Look, guys, it looks like little support. A support right there between the fingers. Do you think we can do it? I think